Next exam is then motor examination, which is a very important part of the nervous system examination. By examining the motor system, you should do inspection, tone assessment, the power, and the reflexes. What we'll do here is we'll examine the upper limbs, and then we'll do the lower limb examinations. So this is a very good way to assess the motor in the upper limbs. I will start with the inspection. Make sure you have a good exposure of the subject. I have a very decent and very adequate exposure. You can sometimes go up to the shoulder, but this is a very decent exposure here. I will inspect now. Always remember to compare both sides. So my inspection, and I'm looking here, so there is no muscle wasting that I can see. I'm looking for muscle wasting. Again, there is no muscle wasting. There is no abnormal movements or muscle contractions, and I don't see any fasciculations. I have to look for fasciculations even in more details. Ahmed, relax. So I'm looking for fasciculation here. I don't see any fasciculations. Again, I can induce fasciculations, but I don't see any. Okay. And no abnormal postures and no abnormal movements again. So by inspection, it is a normal motor exam by inspection. Next will be the tone examination. The first thing to do is you have to get the subject to relax. Muhammad, relax. So he's relaxed, and when I do the motor, the tone, I will go from the top and I'll go down. So I have to assess the muscle tone at rest. Ahmed Arkhi, relax. He's really relaxed. I have to compare. Ahmed, relax again. So this is the shoulder, and then I do elbow movement, or muscles around the elbow, and then supination, pronation. Wrist rotation, and then I try to do finger flexion extension. So he was relaxed. This is a normal tone. There is no either increased tone or reduced tone. There is no hypertonia or hypotonia. To be more specific when you examine the tone, I will look now for spasticity and I will look for rigidity. I will start with spasticity. I'm going to relax. Remember, spasticity is speed dependent, velocity dependent, and it's only unidirectional. In the upper limbs, you should be able to elicit it with extension. Relax. And it is velocity dependent. You have to apply speed. Relax. So it is nice and smooth. I don't see any catch. I don't see any increased tone when I apply this quick movement to the elbow. Relax, relax, relax. Okay, so relax. I do the same for supination pronation. There is no spastic catch. There is no increased tone with speed. Relax, relax. So there are no signs of spasticity. Now I will look for rigidity. And it is simply the way that you do when you examine the tone. Relax. Now I'm looking for rigidity. So rigidity doesn't need any speed, and if you see any rigidity, it will be bidirectional, either, which I mean in flexion, extension, in contrast to spasticity, which is only extension in the upper limbs. So I'm looking for rigidity now, and there is no rigidity. So this is a normal tone examination, no signs of spasticity, rigidity, or hypotonia. Next exam is the motor examination. And as I do the exam, as I did with the tone, I have to start proximal, and then I go all the way down distal. This is also true for the lower limbs. So I will start with shoulder abduction, and at least he's able to lift both shoulder up, which means the power is at least 3. Now I have to put my resistance to see is it 4 or 5. Muhammad, lift it up. Don't let me push it down.
Okay.
Push up, up. Very good. So it is full resistance, full power. The grade is 5 out of 5. Ahmed, elbow flexion. Exactly. So this is the elbow flexion. I'll do the same. Ahmed, push, push, to pull toward you. It's very strong. Pull toward you. This is very strong. And this is the power of 5. Again, I start proximal and you compare each time, each side. Now, Mohammed, push my hand, push down. It's elbow extension, which is very strong. Elbow extension, which is very strong. Now you can extend both arms and lift the put the wrist up. So this is wrist extension. Again, at least three. I have to apply my power to look at exactly the grade. This is full, this is five. This is five. Now the other way around, Mohammed, so you get it. This is wrist flexion. Again, it's at least three. Let me see, is it five or four? Up, 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 strong. Push up, 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 strong. So this is a five. Now finger extension. Have my fingers up. No, both, yeah. Finger up, finger extension, finger extension. Come on, this is full power. No finger flexion. Pull me, pull, pull, pull. So this is strong. This is strong, thank you. So I examined the power, started proximal, and then I went all the way down to distal. The power were symmetric, and they were 5 out of 5 bilaterally. So he has a normal power examination. The last part is I will do the reflexes. In order to do the reflexes, in the upper limbs, we do have three reflexes that you should do. The biceps, the brachioradialis, and the triceps. For any reflex, make sure you expose the muscle of the interest, you locate the tendon, and you look at the muscle, and then you hit. I usually recommend this long rubbery hammer because when you do the reflex, you don't want to hit directly. You want the hammer to go smooth by itself. So this is because this is rubbery, it can really go bounce, hit very gently instead of you hit forcefully. I will show the examination of the reflexes now. Again, so I will start with this position. While he's sitting, with this position, I can do the three reflexes all at once. So I will start with the biceps on the right side. The muscle is exposed. I try to locate the tendon. Mohammed, relax. You should always get your subject to relax. Mohammed, relax. Berkhi. And then hit. Mohammed, relax. I can feel the contraction and you can see it. If it doesn't look as dramatic or marked as you think, you can augment or enhance the reflex. Or do some technique to augment the reflex. Mohammed. Go, and you can see it even more. Relax. So this is the biceps. The grade here is about 2+. I was able to elicit the reflex even before augmentation, but I asked him to augment it to make it easier for you to observe it. Again, for the other side, the biceps, the muscles exposed. I look at my tendon, Mohammed, relax. Relax. Ask him to relax, and he can feel the contraction. You can do the same, Mohammed, augment. Right? And you can feel it is a little bit more. So this is the bicep on the other side, which is normal. Grade 2+. Brachioradialis is the muscle that flicks the elbow. And I can show you the muscle. Lift up if I focus. So this is the muscle, and you can see it goes all the way to the medial aspect of the forearm. So at least I can hit here. Here's the tendon. Again, so I expose the muscle. I locate my tendon. Mohammed, relax. Get him to relax. And you can see the muscle contracting. Now, the other side is, this is the muscle, expose it. I look at my tendon. Mohammed, relax. Relax. And you can see there is some contraction. Even sometimes if there is wrist extension because of the brachioradialis contraction, don't look at the wrist extension, look at the muscle. Because this is a brachioradialis muscle, it is not a reflex, it's not wrist extension reflex. The last upper limb reflex is the triceps. Relax. So it is exposed, and I can see it here. Thank you. So it is exposed. I locate my tendon. You can hit on the tendon directly without putting your finger. Relax. And you can see the contraction. And he can feel it, and he can see it. The other side, I will expose. Relax, and it is there. There is another way to do the reflex for the upper limbs to make it easier. Mohammed, relax. I expose the muscle. Relax. I look at my tendon, and you can see the contraction. don't look at the elbow extension, look at the triceps, because the triceps reflex. And you can do the same with the other side, relax. Thank you. You can also do another small reflex, which is not commonly done, which is the finger flexion reflex, and relax. So I get, this is a finger flexors, I get the fingers to flex. You can see it. When I hit, it goes finger flexion. Yeah, I can feel it. I'm at relax. This is another easy reflex to get. You may get used to do it. One more reflex that you may do in the upper limbs, which is looking for Hoffman sign. Hoffman is an equal a test to the Babinski in the lower limbs. It's a sign for an upper motor neuron lesion. Relax. So you didn't see anything, which is normal. So the brisk finger flexion with Hoffman is pathological indication of an upper motor neuron sign. And relax. So you didn't really see that much of finger flexion. So pathologically, again, you will look for very brisk, exaggerated finger flexors. We concluded the motor examination through the inspection, tone, power, and reflexes. And Muhammad has a normal motor examination in the upper limbs. I will quickly now demonstrate the examination in the lower limbs. I will now demonstrate the motor examination of the lower limbs. Ideally, it should be on the right side of the patient, but I will do it here on the left side just because of demonstration. Again, I will follow the same system. I will do the inspection, tone, power, and reflexes. I will go without explaining the steps that I'm doing. So by inspection, he's exposed fully. You should get even more exposure, but this is ideal. This is adequate. Looking for, again, no wasting, no fasciculation that you can see. No abnormal postures, no abnormal movements. Next is the tone. Muhammad, relax. The tone examination, get him to relax. This is normal tone. This is also looking for rigidity. There is no rigidity. There is no rigidity with normal tone. I want to examine now spasticity. Muhammad, relax. There is no spasticity. So normal tone examination, the lower limbs. Next is the power, start with the right leg. Ahmed, أثني ركبتك. أسحب عليك كده. All the way, أسحب عليك. Try to resist me. So I will apply resistance. This is normal hip flexion with the other side. Ahmed, resist me. This is normal hip flexion on the left as well. I will do now hip extension. Ahmed, push down. اضغط تحت, اضغط تحت, تحت. Hip extension of the left is normal. On the right is normal. The other way to do it is to get him to flip over and then extend the hip. But what I did is still adequate and he has a normal hip extension. I'll do now knee flexion. Pull it toward you. So this is normal knee flexion. Now, this is hip extension, knee extension, which is normal. With the other side, so left knee flexion is normal, extended. Knee extension is normal. Now we'll go down to the dorsiflexion, plantar flexion. Ahmed, the ankle, pull it up exactly. So at least looking at the ankle flexion, this is at least 3. We'll try my resistance to see what it is exact grade. Ahmed, pull toward you. This is very strong. Pull toward you. This is very strong. So this is normal. Ahmed, now go the other way around, down. This is plantar flexion. Again, Ahmed, pull, push down. This is normal, push down. This is normal, relax, thank you. So he has a normal motor examination of the lower limbs. Again, I started proximal and then I went all the way down to the distal. Next is the reflexes. I have 2 reflexes to examine, as well as the Babinski sign. I'll examine the knee reflex and the ankle reflex. For the knee reflex, expose the muscle as if it is exposed, as it should be exposed. Get him to relax. Get him to relax. This is the tendon, and you can see the muscle contracting. You should look at the contracting muscle, not the ankle, not the leg or the knee extending. To the other side, exposing the muscle, adequate, relax. You can do this, we commonly do this, at least you secure he's relaxed. Ahmed, relax. I have the knee tendon exposed, and the muscle idea should be exposed. Relax, and I look at the muscle. So this is a ankle, the knee reflex, which is symmetric. Now for the ankle, we usually do triple flexion. So I flex the hip, I flex the knee, and some gentle flexion of the ankle. It's just a gentle flexion. Expose the gastrocnemius muscle, then I hit. You can see very nice and easy elicited reflex. I do that is the same for the other side. Some hip flexion, knee flexion, and a gentle ankle flexion. Relax, don't help me. Gentle ankle flexion, and you can see the muscle contracting. Thank you. Finally, I have to do Babinski sign, which is an upper motor neuron sign, which equals to the Hoffman in the upper limbs. And for the Babinski, you have to scratch, gentle but yet adequate scratch of the sole of each foot. You come from lateral and go all the way medial, and you look for response or no response. The normal response is flexion of the big toe and the other toes. Pathological response, which is positive Babinski, is the what we call upgoing plantar, or the upgoing flexion of the big toe, or dorsiflexion. We'll examine this now. Ahmed, relax. I'm going to scratch the foot.
Okay.
Sometimes you have to give the patient some hints because it may be a little bit annoying to some patients. Ahmed, relax, Ahmed. So from lateral, I go all the way medial. And if you look at the toes, if they went down, you can do it again to confirm. And the big toe even goes down. Sometimes it stays the same, which would be, this is what we call equivocal. It may have no clinical implication, but definitely if it goes up, it is pathological. I will do the other side as well. Muhammad, relax, Muhammad. So it goes down or equivocal. So this is a negative Babinski, which is a normal response. So again, the motor examination of the lower limbs were normal for the inspection, for the tone, for the power, and the reflexes.